social issues. My name is Kimberly Tate Malone, and if you've been here before, you've heard me say this spiel about a million times. But if you haven't, the library holds this every Thursday, almost every Thursday, because we see it as an extension of our charge to promote the freedom of information and open exchange of ideas. So whether or not you agree with every single thing that you hear in this room or find on our shelves, we want everyone to be exposed to a wide range of viewpoints so that we can learn and grow from each other's experiences, ideas, and expertise. So this is going to be a conversation-based session. So, you know, stretch out your jaws, get ready to talk. And we ask that everyone engage in a lively but respectful conversation today. So next week, we're going to have Dr. Valerie Hunt and Dr. Patricia Russell will be leading a session on racism and its impact on mental health and well-being. But today, I want you to join me in welcoming our presentation. It is.
And today,
we have Katie Denver, faculty librarian, and generally wonderful thinker and person, who will be here to guide us in our discussion around conscious consuming and how is stuff, buying stuff, related to justice. One more hand clap for Katie Denver.
I'm not an expert in this field at all, but I've come to wanting to have this conversation over lots of like casual conversations in our office and with other students because I just am genuinely curious about what people in my community, that's you, think about when they consume stuff. So what does that mean when I say like, things we consume. Yeah.
Things we eat.
Yeah. Eat, drink, say
again.
Food, clothes, everything. Yeah. Say that last part again.
Education, buy.
Yeah. Basically, that's kind of the way I think it too. Things we buy, sometimes maybe even things we don't buy.
Everything we purchase.
Purchase? Yeah, everything we purchase. Sometimes I consume things I don't purchase, like if someone gives me something. So it's things, typically things we spend money on, but also some other things. And then this idea of justice, so the talk is officially called social justice, but I wanted to add the idea, I don't have to write it down, I want to add the idea that environmental justice is also part of this question of consumption. So, we're talking about things we buy, things we eat, things we wear, things we consume, and then related to social and environmental justice. So, to frame the conversation a little bit, we consider our own values in this discussion, and those will be different for all of us. And then to consider our identities and positionality. So that's really important in thinking about consumption and about justice. Some examples for myself. So I'm faculty here at Seattle Central. It means that I have a salary. My salary is regularly given to me because I have tenure. And that puts me in a much different position to talk about consumption than a lot of other people. And I'm totally aware of that. I am a woman, so sometimes the world looks at my consumption in different ways than men. An example is I was getting car insurance set up the other day. By the way, having a car is lucky, and it's based on my other positionality. But someone sent me an estimate for my car insurance and said, you might want to look this over with your husband. So I don't think when men get a car insurance quote that someone says, you might want to look this over with your wife. It's just my guess. So that's my kind of identity as a woman. And I'm white. So in consuming things like cars and homes, I get a loan, and those loans are, or have historically been more easily given to people who identify as white. So all these kinds of things need to be taken into account when we talk about consumption. And it's an opportunity for us to not judge each other based on those things and not judge ourselves as we have this conversation. So come with questions and not judgment, please. Okay, so a couple of other things to frame the discussion or to give examples. So who has drank water? Yay, it's universal. So again, consuming things gives us an opportunity to ask questions. What questions might you ask when you consume water?
Can you say my body can consume it?
Yeah, say that again, so something about your body.
Like when you drink that, like you should only consume like maybe 70%.
Oh.
And then you will make up the 70%.
Yeah, we're 70% water. Mm-hmm. Yeah. What else? Did you have a hand up back there?
Oh yeah. What kind of water is
it? Yeah, what kind of water is it?
Where does it come from?
Where does it come from? That's a really good question. Mahim, could you put your hand up?
I think what's going to happen with the bottle after this?
Yeah, especially if the water comes in this form. What's going to happen to the bottle afterwards? Anything else? Yeah, where did it go? So I wanted to use this as an example because I think about 10 years ago here at Central, the integrative project theme through the Learning Communities Committee was water. And there was a student group, or actually I think many student groups, who after studying and learning about water and consuming water, especially bottled water, they decided that they didn't want water, bottled water, to be sold on our campus anymore. So they fought very, very hard to get water taken out of the vending machines and the restaurants and cafes on campus. And the administration was very opposed because they were going to lose money. So students agreed to buy permanent water bottles from auxiliary services to kind of make up some of the difference for the funding. It took a lot of work and a lot of fighting, but it was very conscious on these students' parts that they wanted this community to consume water in maybe more environmentally just ways. So I think that's triumphant. And then I did notice that recently, or like over the last couple of years, water has made its way back into back into the cafe, back into the vending machines. So maybe that's a fight we want to take up again. Okay, so who knows this story? Yeah, anybody want to tell me a little bit about who this guy is?
I don't know, I'm not super knowledgeable about it, but I know Colin Kaepernick, he's picked with San Francisco 49ers. He's, and he made, I guess, another big media thing about, you know, taking the answer part of Black Lives Matter movement.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah,
do
you want to add anything to that?
Didn't I say it was like disrespectful as you take the knee?
Yeah, so he took the knee. When did he decide he was going to kneel? During the national anthem. And his protest was about his life and the lives of Black Americans. And it has become controversial. And also, it has become connected to consuming. So not long after Colin Kaepernick took the knee at a San Francisco 49ers football game, this happened. So people started buying his jersey a lot. And it's really interesting to me, again, an opportunity to ask questions. So what questions do you have about this? Where's the money going? That's what I want to know too. So I tried to figure that out, and guess what? It's really complicated. But I know a little bit about it, and I know a little bit about it from Colin Kaepernick himself, who tweeted or put on Instagram or both that he felt really honored that his jersey had sold so much and that he was going to donate his money from jersey sales to community organizations. So basically, this kind of helped me a lot in thinking about my questions, because I think it's great that Kaepernick is actually getting money for the sale of his jerseys. He doesn't get all of it. It's very complicated. It has to do with the players' union. But it was a good thing. Okay, and if you want to know more about it, I'll tell you afterwards, because it's kind of crazy. Okay, so now I want to open up the floor for discussion. And here are some questions that, and I want people to kind of discuss at their tables. I'll join one of the tables, and then we'll save some time at the end for everyone to share what they've been talking about. So you can choose to talk about these questions or whatever else you want to talk about related to the topic. And they are, what are ways to think about social or environmental justice when we buy or consume things? What are ways you personally have thought about these things? And should we make personal goals about conscious consumption? Okay, so talk amongst yourselves. And I'm gonna join you guys.
Realistically, it's better to purchase those cars than to buy them. So I think like it's not so simple to buy things that are environmental friendly and all that. There's a lot of backlogs.
Thank you.
Well, another thing is, especially if I listen to the difference is kind of similar. And people may have thrown trash when they match it hard.
Go ahead and keep buying it.
Because
discussion. I also just think about ways that options to buy, not buy business. Kind of put pressure on people that don't have the option.
Yeah, I'm literally asking to make up for like
cost of a week.
I don't know, so it just said that.
You choose, like, social media, you choose the bias.
So, do you think it's true that, like, if we make a difference,
Pretty well.
Our group had such a good conversation over here, so I don't wanna like throw anyone out there.
I think we did too, we had a good conversation, and with the whole people, took some effort, some hearing effort.
I'll just say one thing, maybe prompt you guys to. We were talking about how it can feel lonely to try to consume on our own, and trying to connect with other people is a really important part of that, or to consciously consume on our own, so,
It's like when you think of an issue, you tend to think of like the big picture, right? Then it can get really overwhelming as one like individual, so like a way to combat that is like then keep doing your own thing, you know, and then find people that are like-minded, and then you get together and you start something, like how you said with the plastic water bottles. So like take it one step at a time, because there's only so much truth to you as an individual, but when you get a lot of people together, that's when you can make like a huge impact.
I that's interesting. We talked a little bit about that, and I, to prepare for this, I did research about boycotts because I wanted to find all these amazing examples of how consumers had this huge impact, and there aren't many because it's very hard. There are some, but it takes a lot of people and a lot of time. So we discussed a little, like, is it enough to have our own values drive consumption? Or like, at what times is it just okay for it to be just my decision? So it's interesting to hear you guys talk about like the kind of spectrum of like going it alone and then like working up to a movement. Yeah. Anybody else talk about that?
Taking the lead, and if anybody had like the plastic bottle, taking the lead, limiting plastic bottle out of school, and like if any students or people have a question, educating, having an education system like this, like little classes, and oh, there's class on Thursday, you can go learn why plastic bottles are bad for you and for the environment, you know, those little movements, like having an education system. Yes.
Yeah, I think one like structural way that the college does that is the integrative assignments. And I don't know, is anyone participating in integrative assignments? So it's place and space this year? There is such a thing. You might be in a class that participates, and they're often focused on social and environmental justice. They probably always are, in fact. So it's a way to really dig in and learn about issues.
Well, we talked a lot about how it's important to, you know, try and have like seasonal diet and, you know, like consume locally as much as we can, but also like not just think about the product, you know, from when you buy it to when you eat it, but think about it, you know, how it was conceived, who packaged it, where was it made, what was, you know, went into bring it to your shelves, and what was it gonna, you know, be required to recycle it, you know, or compost it, or like throw in the trash, and you know what that process entails. So thinking about all those things, you know, makes it makes a big decision on what you choose to buy and what not.
Yeah, it's a lot of labor involved when you think about it that way. So I think it's like impossible to think at that level about everything, but some of those questions in mind when I go to the store or whatever. Yeah.
You talked a little bit about how consumption is really tied a lot to culture. So we have two individuals that are not born and raised in the United States, and how consumption is so much different here than maybe where they come from. So, and I think oftentimes that puts us, we feel pressure to consume like others, and so if we don't kind of buy into what everyone else is doing, now you're kind of an outsider, and how that makes you feel that you're different, and oftentimes bad different, because you're not kind of participating like anyone else.
That's about that a lot.
So I learned this from the other class. It's like when you see something on social media, like for example, if everyone is using it, everyone is buying it, then you have to buy it too to be able to be back to be called cool, free, and stuff. Because
mm-hmm.
That's our society.
Mm-hmm.
That's
yeah, social media is really good at that, making you feel bad about things you don't have.
That's
true.
Yeah.
It's kind of what we talked about too with Amazon being such an essential thing to also everybody's lives, and you know, because we like we want things quick and fast, and they're able to do that because they get to have onto our expectations and what we want in society. And so it's like, but yet again, they're doing also things that I know they're really against, like, you know, probably all of them. Still, it's like an idea that one of our group members had was like, if we're gonna continue consuming, like do something for the community, or else if you don't, then we're not gonna be consuming things.
Kind of bouncing off to
like companies, the only way they are what they are is because of the consumers, you know, so holding them accountable to everything, to how like your products affect like the community, you just, you gotta hold them accountable and be like, hey, you control you, you control us.
Yeah, that's really empowering. Did anybody else talk about Amazon?
That's amazing, isn't it?
Well, I mean, they're right in the backyard, right? So what other things about Amazon are noteworthy in this conversation?
I think we heard about the,
oh, no, go ahead, go.
Have you heard about the mayor in here that can do that, the Amazon, but the Amazon is trying to do,
yeah, so this story that the city council passed a head tax to tax companies larger than 500 employees, I believe, and then they took away the head tax, and it was discovered that the mayor was talking to the Hanauers, and I think Jeff Bezos, basically, that the people who lead these large companies had influence over the mayor. She took the head tax away. Amazon promised in return that they would build this building, and they halted their construction on the building, or their planning for it. So there's a lesson there.
They pulled out of that project like 2 days ago.
Mm-hmm.
What? They pulled out of the project in which they were threatening to pull out of. They pulled out anyway, you know, mm-hmm. like on last Friday.
Yeah,
you
have a lot of power.
Can you put your hand up? I was just going to say, we were talking about like questioning how much our purchasing power really matters and how Amazon owns Whole Foods or like Crest toothpaste owns Tom toothpaste. So when you think you may be supporting something that's more like a natural alternative, you may just be supporting a really large corporation. I think it's important to think that you have like that you're going to be able to make a change, but it's also important to recognize, like, yeah, but can we really all just stop buying groceries for a month? Like, what's going to happen? It's not really going to make a difference. Like, how much can we really do? Like, if, I don't know. It's hard to put it into perspective.
Mm-hmm. Yep, I have a little stomach ache about it, actually. Yeah, I can't believe it.
And,
but, like, how it feels impossible to think about every single thing, every purchase that you make, everything that you put in your mouth, and not only that we consume and wear, but also like the media that we consume, or talking about like musical artists and movie stars and all those things, so like really problematic behaviors and predatory behaviors, and are we going to do research into every single producer that produced the album, into every single artist that's on the album, into every single writer that wrote the songs? Or we just kind of wait until we hear about it in the news, and then we are kind of like reactive. But that feels like so much work and almost pretty much impossible task to research every single thing that we do before we do it to make sure no harm we do. Yeah.
Yeah, and that's kind of a big question still hanging out there. It's like, all right, so then what?
I have a question. So I've heard this question before. It's like, are we in control of our attitudes?
Are we in control of our
since
attitudes?
Since you see something in social media and then...
Mm. Yeah, are we in control of our attitudes, and are we in control of what we buy?
Maybe that.
Yeah. I don't know. That's a good question. Go ahead, yeah.
Well, I was just kind of tying some of what people have said with, you know, on the one hand, our sort of consumption culture and society wants to compartmentalize us. Everybody needs one, you know, their own, whatever it is, tissue, dishwasher. But then turning that, when we're kind of thinking about the implications of our decisions, like the onus is on us to do all the research. And, you know, we were discussing the importance, kind of questioning that premise and the importance of regulations and government regulations. In the case of Amazon, you know, collective action, as you see in New York, where there are sort of hopeful flashes of power, people power, but kind of, yeah, I think you can get in that spiral of, I have to research all this stuff to know that I'm doing a good job, and it can get very lonely and tiresome and depressing, and in the end, maybe there really shouldn't be, there should be more societal structures to make all that, you know, just information accessible, make sure it's not happening in the first place, really.
Yeah, I heard a couple of things where I liked collective action. We have the power to do that. Even in things we consume, we can have roommates, or we can have help in making decisions. And also, the possibility that there are policy-driven, or that there are policies that are in alignment with our values, and so supporting people who support those policies is important.
And then you said something about like a tweak. I don't know what you said, but it made me think about, someone sent me this site, The Intentionalist, and it's really interesting because you can search like coffee. You can do it yourself, I won't show you. So if you're here, you give your address and you say coffee, and it gives you a list of businesses, and the tags are like Black-owned business, woman-owned business, LGBTQ-owned business, family-owned business. So for me, I like knowing that. Dave observed that it's not all businesses are in there, but I think it's new and it's building, and to me it's really impressive. There are carbon calculators, of course, if you haven't ever calculated your carbon footprint, it's really interesting. And you might stop eating beef, not sure. And then there are lists of woman-owned businesses, Black-owned businesses, et cetera, and I think Kimberly said there was like an app. There are apps for that too. So if that's something like you want to support those kinds of businesses, you can look into that, and of course much, much more. So thank you so much for joining this group today and for a spirited conversation. I feel like we could talk about this a lot more, and maybe we will in the future. And good luck with the rest of the quarter. We're getting close to finals, so yeah, thanks everyone.